Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today we are going to show you three different ways to delete every other row in Microsoft Excel. So the first way we are going to show you to delete every other row in Excel is converting your data into a table and then deleting all of the blue rows. The second way we are going to show you is creating this helper column over here where you get a 1 or a 0 in every other row, and then we are just going to delete all of the zeros. And the third way we are going to show you is with a module we have written in VBA. Also, we will have some additional training options for you at the end of this video, so stick around for that. So for our first example, we are going to start with our raw data right here. And then I'm going to select all of the data and go to the Insert ribbon and click Table. And then I'm going to be prompted for where is the data for my table. And I'm just going to keep the selection that I had. And I also want to check this box that says my table has headers, because in row one, I want this to be seen as the header for each column. So I'm going to click OK. And now I can see that my data has been converted into a table, but not only that, every other row is now this light blue color. So next, if I click this down arrow and I go to sort by color, I can see that I'm getting this custom sort here, but that's not exactly what I want. So if I select my whole table and then I go to table design, I have this option here to convert to range. And so I'm going to go ahead and click that. And then I'm going to be asked, do I want to convert the table to a normal range? And I'm going to say yes. And if you're at the end of your table like I am, if I hit the control up arrow, I can go back to the top. And now if I click an A1 and I go to data and I turn the filter back on, now when I click the down arrow and I go to sort by color, the color blue of every other row is going to show up here. So if I click on that, my data has now been sorted by my row color, which essentially is every other row. So if I highlight 2 and I just drag down here to the end of my blue, and then I hold down shift and select the bottom blue one, I have now essentially selected every other row. Then I can right click and go to delete. And now I'm left with only the white options that were in my table to begin with.
If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos.
So the second way we can get rid of every other row, if I create a new column at the end of my table and I use the mod function, so I'm going to type equals mod with a left parenthesis. And the first argument I'm going to be asked for is a number. So the number I want to use here is actually whatever row number I am on over here. So in this case, I want 2, this case I want 3, 4, etc. So in order to get that row number, I'm going to use the function row with a left parenthesis. And then I can click any cell in this row. So I'm just going to click I2. And then I'm going to close up the row function. So this row with the parenthesis I2 is going to give me the 2 right here. And then the next argument I'm going to be prompted for is the divisor. And in this case, I just want to type a 2. And that is going to tell me whether this is an odd or an even number. So I'm going to end my parentheses for the mod function and hit enter. And then if I click back in that cell, and if I hover over this square at the bottom right-hand corner of the selected cell until I get this cross icon, I can click and drag that to the end of my data set. And then I can scroll all the way back up to the top. And now you can see that every other row is a 0 or a 1. So if I want to get rid of all the ones that have a 0, I can click this down arrow, uncheck the select all, and just check the ones that have 0 and say OK. And then I can highlight that row, and then I can just click the bar over here and just drag to the end of my data set. Hold down the shift key and select my last row so that I select everything. Right click and go to delete row. And now when I take the filter off by clicking select all and say okay, the mod function is going to recalculate over here based on whether or not I'm in an odd or even row. But if I scroll all the way down, I can see that I only have 289 rows in here, whereas I had 577 before. So I know I have deleted half of my rows. And the final option that we have is using a VBA module in here. And we have the code for you out on our blog. And I'm just going to copy and paste it in here for you. So the first thing you want to do when you're using VBA code is to make sure that you go up to File, Save As. And right here, you can see your options for saving an Excel workbook. And you want to make sure you've saved it as a .xlsm so that the macro will be saved with the workbook. Because if you keep it a .slxs, you are not going to be able to save the VBA code to that kind of workbook. So just make sure you have the extension .xlsm. And then I'm going to go back, and on my keyboard, I'm going to hit Alt F11. And this will bring us to the Visual Basic for Applications window. And once you're in here, go to Insert and go right here to Module. And if you go out to our blog with the link below in the description in YouTube and scroll down to step 3 of our third option, you will see this code. So I'm just going to copy this code and Alt-Tab back to Excel and paste it into here. And if you get the line numbers like I did, just backspace those out of here. So if I look at my VBA code, I can see that I have a subroutine called delete every other row. So just remember that name and click the X up here in the top right-hand corner to close out of Visual Basic for Applications and go back to Excel. So now on this sheet, if I go up to View and I click this button over here for macros, I can see the delete every other row macro. If I click on that and I hit Run, but before I do that, I just want you to see that my rows are color-coded. You can see that all of the blue rows have now been deleted. And I know this because if I click here and hit Control and the down arrow, I'm back to 289 rows instead of the original that I had. So hopefully this gives you a good way to delete every other row on a worksheet. If you would like further detail on any of these options, you can go to our blog and the link is included in the YouTube description below. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them for us. Thanks for watching and see you again next time.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.